In this vlog, we are going to see the implementation of a network call where we are going to use both get and post request. So if you have gone through our previous tutorials where we have seen the implementation of get request and post request using Duo library, and in this particular tutorial, we are going to combine both of these things and try to implement at once. So if you are not familiar with the concept of concurrent network calls, then this tutorial will be very much helpful for you. So watch till the end of this tutorial to get to know about the concurrent network call implementation using Duo library. In this particular tutorial, as we have discussed earlier, we are going to deal with both get and post request. So here, if you consider, this is a code for the get request implementation and this one is for post implementation. And now we are going to consider both of them together. So I'm just going to remove all this code. And yes, I just want to specify that this is the URL we are going to use here for both post and get request. And first try to complete with our code and then I will try to show you an example in the postman. Then we'll try to implement it in our Flutter application. So here, let's try to remove this code completely. Let's make use of this particular variable response. Also specify await here, future dot wait, and inside which we need to specify our both post and get request here. So how do we specify is like do dot first, let us try to specify get here, and it's not any compulsion, you can also specify post, but I'm just trying to specify get here and just try to specify the URL which we are going to use here. So I'm just going to make use of this particular URL. I'm just going to copy it and paste it over here. And now let's try to provide the post request as well. So far so good, there are no errors for this particular block of code, and there are few errors over here like response.statusCode and response.data2String. We have two API requests here, that is one is for get and one is for post, so we cannot directly access the response. So we need to specify which particular response we wanted to print over here. So for which, we can just make use of array over here, response, and specify 0 here so that it targets the first element here, and you can just specify the status code here. And now, so here 0 will have the response of get API request here. And now let's try to specify the same for post, and here we are trying to specify 1 here. So you may get a question like, how do we know, are we like manually hard coding 0 and 1 here? It's not any compulsion here, you need not manually hard code it. So you can just try to know the size of or the length of the response array here. So that's it. When you try to print the length of the response here, you will be getting the total length of the response, and it's again a simple thing using a for loop or any other strategy. You can just try to loop through the response and try to fetch the response accordingly. Before trying to run our Flutter application, I just want to show you these two responses in postman so that you will be getting a clarity, and then we'll try to run our application here. So if you see here, the same URLs we have just added in our get and post calls here. And when you try to run this, so this is the output we are going to observe here. So for the get API request, the output is too large. And let's try to confine it to just 1 here. So that is ID 1 here. And now you can see just we got only 1. So here, as we have specified 1 here, we are getting the data for ID 1 here. And when you specify 2 here, we'll be getting the data for the ID 2 here. So in this way, we can try to get this specific data. So I'm just trying to confine with 1 here and also go back to our code, and in the get API request, try to add it for 1 itself. And now let's try to see the post API implementation. So when you try to make a post implementation here, we have added name and email. So if you are having any query like why we have added these two things, please go through this particular tutorial. I have explained here like why we have added a post API, I mean why we have added these two parameters, name and email here, and how we can make a post API request. We have got a status code like 201 for post and 200 for get API call. So now let's try to run our code and try to observe our status code which we are getting in our Flutter application. So let's try to open our simulator here and try to run our code. And here we have got the output for our Flutter application over here. And here we can see we have got this particular button post data. So we can just slightly append it like get by post data, so that we are trying to make a network call for both post and get, right? So let's try to tap on this particular button and try to observe the output here. So here clearly you can see 200 and 201. So what is the 2 here? Response.length. The length of the response is like 2 here. 2 consists of both get and post here. And to get the data, we are trying to make use of 0. As we got 2 here, like we don't specify 1 and 2, right? So from in arrays, from the indexing will start from 0. So we are specifying 0 and 1 here accordingly. And so that is the size of the response.length here. And for Flutter, status code for 0 position is like get API call, and the status code is like 200, which we can observe the same in postman also. And for post API request, we have got 201, and again, which is the same we are observing in our postman here. So this makes sure that our concurrent network call is successfully implemented. And also, instead of status code, you can just try to specify data here so that our data is get successfully printed now. And when you tap on this particular button, you'll be getting the data even. So here for the get API request, so this is the output like user ID 1, ID 1 and title and body here. If you observe our console here, we just got user ID 1, ID 1 and title and body here. And also for the post API request, we have got the response like 101. So 101 is the ID of the data which we have inserted. So again, I'm specifying in the post API tutorial, I have clearly explained like why we got ID 101 as a response. So here you can see we have got ID 101 even here also. So this is it for this particular tutorial, and I hope you have understood clearly like both our get and post API calls are being implemented here, and that too concurrently. Just on a single button tap, we are able to make both get and post API request, the two very quick, I can say, like as we have specified within 1 minute. And you can clearly see like to write this particular block of code, it's sufficient time, like 1 minute is a very sufficient time. So yeah, that's it for this tutorial. And go through the previous tutorials if you are having any queries in the get and post API call implementation. So yes, this is it for this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.